Bryan Crabtree talking about the Charleston Tri-County real estate market. So what will home prices do this year? What should they do? Is the market real? Is it artificial? Well, a real quick snapshot of the market right now. We have about double the inventory of 18 to 24 months ago before interest rates went up through the roof. And what we've seen is this market defy gravity. Some estimates put the average net new people relocating into the market, meaning population increase, at somewhere around 45 per day. Well, I can tell you we're not creating new houses at that rapid pace. Even though there's a lot of apartments going up, I kind of joke we need more apartments in the Charleston Tri-County area, like anyone needs a hole in the head. But, you know, we wish that they were building some condominiums and townhomes for people to actually buy, live in, and be homeowners. But there has been a large growth in apartments. And that certainly is part of the equation. But most people coming to the Charleston area are coming here either because they can work remotely, they're retiring, or they've gotten a job in some of the industries such as the automobile industry or the aviation industry. So they want to be in a home. They want to own a home, and there just aren't enough homes for sale. Therefore, prices due to supply and demand economics keep rising. The number one factor that's going to shape the housing prices in any market, including the Charleston, Tri-County, and coastal South Carolina areas going forward for the next decade, is going to be jobs, income, and the unemployment number. The unemployment number is 3.7%. The jobs market is outpacing all expectations and predictions. And while there could be the prediction of a mild recession later in 2024, it would take a massive jobs loss, which does not appear to be in the cards, for real estate prices to have true downward pressure. Or we'd have to have interest rates at 9 or 10% sustained. At this point, if we look at what the market is sort of telling us and what it's predicting, is that we should see interest rates fall into the fives, possibly even the low fives, by very late this year or early next year. That's not a given, but it's possible, maybe even likely. We should see jobs continue to be strong, even if a little weaker, even if the unemployment rate ticks up to 5%. That's not going to necessitate any kind of real estate crisis. And as far as defaults go right now, the foreclosure and default industry is struggling. And when the foreclosure and default industry in mortgage is struggling, that means the real estate market is uber super strong. So it would take a massive change, not only a momentum shift from rapidly advancing in terms of demand, prices, and the overall economics of housing, it would then have to be neutral, which is we would have a period of time sort of like seeing the market kind of wobble a little bit, which we have not seen yet. And then we would have a decline. So we're looking at a couple of years before a real crisis could even brew, if one occurs at all. Now, there are places in the Charleston area, we see like Edisto Island really shot up late in the game. And we saw prices on beach-oriented properties go through the roof from like $600,000 to $1.3 million over the course of 2 years. And those prices have come back down a couple hundred thousand. But I've always analyzed the market by saying the top price that something sells for in a given community is never a true component of appreciation. It's just a few people paid too much. That's it. You know, if you sell 100 houses in the course of a year in a given area, and the last 5 or 10 of them sell way higher than everything else, that doesn't mean appreciation reached that higher number. You always throw out the highest 10% and the lowest 10%, and the truth is somewhere in the middle. So what we've really seen is a mild correction on places in the Charleston area that have overshot, like Edisto Island, Folly Beach with a new Airbnb and short-term rental restrictions and certain parts of Mount Pleasant on the higher end. But in the averages of the market, we still see single-digit strong appreciation, and I am rather confident. You know, I've always been kind of a pessimist more than an optimist when it comes to stock market values and real estate values in terms of the short-term and markets like this. I just don't see any evidence that we won't see a sort of middle single digits increase in values this year, which means prices and the market are going to get less and less affordable. And as I've said in other videos, waiting on an interest rate to come down is going to be the worst scenario, because whatever you save in interest in the short term before rates level out, you're going to lose and then some in real estate pricing, at least in the Charleston Tri-County area, which is arguably one of the most popular inbound relocation areas in the country. HouseDog.com to reach out to me for your buying or selling needs. Or if you need mortgage, private money, investment money, any commercial mortgage, any kind of lending, I do all that too. HouseDog.com, connect with me there. Thanks for tuning in.